Hi everyone, my name is Natalie and I love creating landscapes with fluid art. The painting you see right behind me, I created this some months ago and I really love it. And I entitled it Homage because it's an homage. It's dedicated to all the great fluid artists on YouTube, of which I learned my techniques. And I'm happy that two of them, Dwight Myers and Chris Schneider, I will be doing a great collaboration with today. This part of the painting is actually inspired by Dwight, and these parts are inspired by Chris, and I will show you some of their pictures and you will, I think, see why.
Here are two of Chris' adorable landscapes with their big skies and straight lines achieved by multiple flip cups flipped and dragged slowly across the canvas. And this is Dwight Myers' more abstract work, a dump and swirl and a pearl pool, very minimalistic and so stunning. My inspiration for today is the view from my window, and here we start doing our cloudscape. I use base coats mixed with satin enamels. You will find more details in the description box. And now I fill some cups for some flip cups. More about the colors used you find also in my description box. I fill three small cups, one with more cold tones, one with warm shades, and one with a mix of both. The base coat is very thin. It's one very light gray base coat and one off-white color. They both contain house paint, some satin enamel, some normal acrylic, and some floatful and pouring medium and water. Chris Schneider always wishes her flip cups good luck. My certainly needed because I'm not as skilled in flipping and tilting my cups. This is tilted very slowly. The video speed is 5 times faster. I found that the silver kind of covered up some of the blue, so I applied more blue where I wanted to have water to suggest the San Francisco Bay. I apply some silver and some light pink cloud mix near the horizon line and some more metallic charcoal for contrast and some metallic pewter, which I actually forgot to put in my cups. That's why I apply it here. It's a lovely color. As you've seen in the beginning, I try to create a landscape with a city in the foreground, and that's why I do those swipes here. The diagonal swipes are supposed to create some perspective, and the vertical ones are supposed to suggest houses, but you will see me changing this part a lot of times because it didn't quite work the way I wanted in the first place. So now I had another flip cup of color because it was just too messy and busy, and too much of the blue from the water dragged into the foreground that I didn't want. Reworking the horizon line. I mainly use a mix of Amsterdam paint, white, and a titanium bluff color mixed with floor tool to swipe and smear with. It does create some nice cells and lacings, sometimes too much for that part, which is why I will later go in with some other paints to make it less busy. See, now I apply some of the silver to actually take away some of the cells and lacings that I found too busy. When you see my hair on my head, that's when I blow on the paint to spread it out. Some smears with the Amsterdam paint applied to a kitchen spatula, and then I decide to redo the foreground because it didn't look the way I wanted it to look. I wanted it to be a bit more minimalistic and abstract. So I put some of my off-white base coat to just erase the parts that I didn't like. And now I recreate some of the shapes of the horizon and the houses in the foreground with a stick and palette knife. You can already see some pearl cells developing now at the right side of this water area and also in the cloud part. This type of painting with thin paints and satin enamel in the base changes a lot while you work. So this part of my process is really my own style. I don't think Chris or Dwight ever fiddle that much with their paintings. It comes closer to more traditional style of painting, I think. Except that I don't use a brush, but other tools for it. But the whole painting is starting to look already a lot more like I wanted it to look. I'm really glad that I let the sky part untouched after the initial pour of the base coats and just let the paints react and do their thing. I like the minimalistic yet dramatic look of it. I will show it to you in the end. I'm really quite impressed by it. I don't think I ever got such nice big pearl cells before. I like that there's a lot more color in the middle section and more neutral shades at the top and at the bottom. And this is a finished painting, already dry. I didn't film the wet result, or I did film it, but the quality wasn't good enough to show. But it didn't change that much more because the painting process was so long that it had already fully developed by the time I finished painting. So it's a quite abstract and dramatic sky with those big pearl cells. A few pearl cells in the land and water area. Some shimmery tones of the silver and charcoal and pewter metallic. This is how it looks in bright sunlight. I just wanted to show you the shimmer, and this is in normal daylight. Yeah, the details that I really like about this painting. The sky part and the land part. And I think you can see the inspiration by my fellow artists. Please check out Chris and Dwight's channel. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe.